some days of my life were spent dreading appointments. It's hard to explain. Appointments, even if they're down the road, perhaps especially in that circumstance, tend to weigh on my mind and bug me, like little claim markers on time. You know, and I'd rather not know. I'd rather suddenly have to do something than know that I will suddenly have to do something but can't do it yet until 3 weeks from Thursday. So when stuff like that comes up, and I know that they're lined up, and we have recurring ones, like taps on your veins, every single week, I've never been one to actually even come close to enjoying appointments. Now, I know you might think of appointments in a different category. Like, if you think of appointments, you just might think, oh, well, you know, the dentist or the doctor, you know. With me, it's like having to do groceries, you know. Tomorrow is a fucking appointment to get groceries. And, you know, classes for Aurora, they're like appointments, right? Show up here at 3 p.m., show up there at 6 p.m., whatever. And I don't think that I can fully reconcile the idea that gone, just gone are the days when I could sit and say nothing on the calendar. The calendar is clean. And I can think about writing, and I can drift, and I can sleep if I want to, and I can work if I want to. All that. All that shifted. If not when married, then definitely when we had a child. So now that she's growing up, and we're homeschooling her, and we're supplementing that homeschooling with different classes in different cities here and there, it's like appointment central. And to somebody else, it just might be, oh no, you know, it's just a handful a week, you know, that's all you do. To me, a handful of appointments each and every week is like, totally undesirable. I don't see why I would want that, but I can understand why it's necessary and why I do it. If I could design my schedule, see, here's another thing. When it comes to driving, Laurie is she's just, you know, one of the last times she drove was to take the car around the block to the garage for a regular yearly sticker for inspection. And when she was driving out, she drove over this very steep curve. It's like, 8 inches, 10 inches, like a boom, curve. And we had been going to this garage for 11 years. It wasn't like it was new territory. It was like around the block from our house and a place that we have gone to at least once a year for 11 years. So, as a result, it started when her insurance was 4 times as much as my insurance for a year on auto. So it was strictly a money thing. But now it's just, you know, I think the period of time where they penalize you is gone. You know, it's like once you passed 5 years of being clean, then it starts all over again. I don't know how the hell it works, but she'd probably be much lower than she used to be to insure. However, as far as driving goes, it's not like she's gotten 5 times better simply because of inactivity. So it's pretty much pretty similar driving ability. And so I'm the one who drives. And each and every appointment isn't like I can lie down in bed saying, okay, well, have a good time, you know, I'll see you when you get back from your appointment. No, each and every appointment involves me. You know, like I have the appointment, and in a way I do, being the chauffeur. So doing all of that is, at times, something I fear. You know, just like another fucking appointment. More so than pain sometimes. You know, pain is just, well, what the fuck, you know? Pain can make me angry. Appointments just make me sad. And as a result, I am more afraid of it. I'm more afraid of simply being sad than I am of getting pissed off. I can deal better with getting pissed off, but when it comes to getting sad and fearful, I don't want the appointment. No! No, please, no. No, not another fucking appointment. Yeah. So, big overreaction fear. Appointments.